So this is the package it comes with, Crest Tour action camera. It is the model CT9000. It's a 4K, 170 degree angle. It's got only just a 2-inch LCD screen, and battery is about 120 minutes. I would say it is potentially slightly less than 120 minutes when you're using 4K, which I am recording in right now, and have been for a little bit, but not too long. So I did repackage this as best I could. Obviously the camera is in here, which is currently on my head. Comes with a nice thank you and support ticket, so you can see if you ever need support. And it has, of course, a manual, if you like to read those things. So inside is all the accessories that this camera comes with. So here we have what looks to be cables, cable ties, things to clean your screen. This is just a clip that you can use. I'll see if I can find them. There's some other clips somewhere around here. Here's one. So this clip here can actually go in here. You push it down, push it in rather, and it just clips in. So the camera will actually seat right there. This one is one you utilize without the case on. It snaps right in, and then you can screw it in to a base or whatever. This thing is pretty nice. I'm not going to accidentally click this, but you can actually take picture and record video with this, and this actually goes on your wrist. Now this is not waterproof, so you do not want to get this thing wet. Here is just some other straps. This was originally I used as a headband, but I made I actually ordered the accessory kit, which came with a really nice headband, but I previously used this as a headband, which did work, just not very secure. Which, of course, with a camera, you want it to be secure. This one has a little screw piece. The camera goes right there. Similar to this one. Screw goes there. This is another clip that you would put. You can actually stick this onto a helmet or something. So you can, like, put this on the side of a car or whatever. There's some really cool angled shots. This one as well is a clip and a screw that screws it in. So you can do a lot of different combinations of the exact same thing. It does come with two batteries. So this is the second battery, which I'm actually about to throw in because my battery is soon to die. The second back piece for the waterproof case. And this is a clamp. It has two screw tight loosening and tightening screws, and a clamp that you can move, so whatever you want to clamp it on. So that's all what comes with the action camera. The action camera does not come with memory cards, so you will need to buy memory cards. What I bought was two Samsung 32 gigabytes. 32 is the max that it can be, so if you are looking to use this camera, I would recommend getting two 32 gig cards, micro SD, and I can also put those a link down below in the description. I got them for just $11.99 a pop, so it's about 22, 23 bucks. With shipping, I think total for me was like 25 bucks for two cards, so not too shabby. And in just a sec, I'm going to go over the accessory kit. So the name of the application I'm actually using is called iSmartDV. iSmartDV is the name of it. So here's the accessory kit that I picked up. Zuki accessories kit for GoPro. And the link will be in the description down below. But it is sold by Zuki Direct. first thing I'll grab here is like a selfie stick. So I already put this little clamp piece on that actually holds the camera. And this piece here, tightened it really tight, actually can make it so it can kind of go in whatever direction you want, which is kind of neat. So this can be extended 48 inches. Has a nice little carrying case, and this is velvet. Set that aside for one sec. This is a hard case that it comes with. It does come with stuff inside of it, so I'll get to that in just a sec. This is actually a dash cam, so has a sticky piece on the bottom. Not sticky, sorry. Suction cup, and you can actually put it on your dash and make use it as like a dash cam. So that's cool. This piece here, I think, is an armband. Yeah, so it's like, or it can go on a helmet, I suppose. But it actually looks to me like it would go on your wrist or something. This is a wrist strap for it, but this is actually like a kind of like a bobber or floater. So you can actually put the camera on here with your waterproof case and use it underwater. It's nice and lightweight, so you can use it underwater, or you can have it, supposedly it floats. So if you have the camera and you put it in the water, this will actually float to the top, so you can get like underwater images or picture. So that's cool. Excited about trying that out. And the camera is in fact waterproof. I have tested it myself. That was the very first thing I tried. So here's one of those clamps that I was talking about. And it just slides right into any of those that we've kind of looked at before. And you take the peg and you put the peg here. So this is what the kind of bolts look like, pegs for it, and they just go in. And you just tighten it. And they're nice and secure. Another strap for whatever you may want to use it for. Another one of these pieces here, and this one's kind of cool. So this can be used on any of the pieces that connect to it, but it's almost like a multi-arm kind of deal. Not sure what I would use this for yet, but if it was something like, say, the dash cam or somewhere on the side of a vehicle, it can be cool and used as to get cool angled shots. And then there's two more in here, another one of these bolt screws, and a basic thing here that actually doesn't give too much room, but it would be good for connecting pieces because it's nice and small. And this one is probably what I'm going to get used the most. It is a really, really strong clamp, and the cool thing about this is it has a built-in thing that holds the camera, and this piece, the top piece of it, you can have it, say, on a backpack, and the camera you can rotate 360 degrees. So you can rotate it as much as you want. So you could put it, for example, clamp it on the front of your backpack, and the camera could be still pointing forward and straight up. So that's really neat. Actually, a chest piece. So I already put a clamp down on there, but what this is you put it on, and it goes around your waist. So it comes with this nice hard case inside. It might not be exactly as it came, but to kind of move stuff around, but more or less it comes with some more bolts and a couple other connecting pieces that I showed before. It comes with circular pieces, which I am actually using one of them on this piece here, and then another clamp, another one of these, a second kind of movable clamp piece. The camera would actually go here, I think, a sticky thing, kind of like a safety thing. So say you're putting it on the front of your vehicle or something moving, you can actually kind of strap it down better with this. And this is a ton of those sticky back pieces, so never will run out of those. And of course the clamp pieces that actually hold it in. Some more of the safety things that will actually keep it secure. And more double-sided tape. So this pack is pretty awesome. I would recommend getting this because by default the only thing you'll get is the camera, and again no memory comes with this camera, so you will need to buy micro SD cards. Up to 32 gig is what it takes. So you'll get this box, but obviously you're not going to want to lug around this cardboard box everywhere you go. So I would recommend getting this accessory kit or something like it. Again, I'll put the description down below. Altogether, for the 41 accessories in addition, as well as the 9 that the camera came with, I would say I paid about 65, 70 bucks. So here is the headband piece I was talking about. It's really nice. And this is the camera in the waterproof case. So this here is the waterproof case. And I can take it out. And all these silver are buttons. So this is the power, connecting it to Wi-Fi, cycling it through from picture to video, capturing it, and settings. The camera itself is really small. It is, I mean, about the full length of my thumb and the width of it. So very, very small camera, but it takes very good video and picture. On the side, you have the HD out and the actual charger, so you can charge your battery or to view it and play it. Here, you push down until you hear it click. And there you got your memory. Again, you have to purchase this separately. So to push it in, press it in. I just held down the front to power it on. And the first thing you'll actually want to do once you get your memory in it is format the card. To do this, you're going to press the front button until you see the settings, and then you're going to hit on the top, OK. And then you are going to scroll down all the way to the bottom to see format. Then you're going to click the button, go down, and hit yes. I'm not going to do it because I already did it, but this will actually format your card. And so you can actually take video and picture, and it'll format the SD card. That's all that's doing. So then you can close out of that. And if I hit the button again a couple times, you'll see now it's on 4K. Now it's on picture. Multiple pictures. This will take, I believe, 4 shots in one. And a timed photo, up to 5-second timer, I believe. And again, back to the settings. So if I go back to the settings real quick, I can actually change the video resolution. So you got a lot of different options. But yeah, I really enjoy this camera already. I haven't used it a ton, but I would recommend it. So thank you for watching. Have a good day.
If you only knew the power.